Good morning, Arthur.
Morning, Arthur.
Hi, Jose. Good morning.
Hello.
All right, boy.
Good morning. Careful with that horse, Arthur.
All right, don't get all worked up. Yep, yep. Hey, Arthur!
What do you want?
Uncle told me something about a train.
What did he say?
Mary Beth overheard something about a train full of wealthy folk rolling down.
Hello.
Yeah.
Get him now!
Shit.
You ain't lying.
This here's an off-limits area.
Calm down.
This ain't a coffee house. It's a tarp.
Get going.
It's over, Tenderfoot! Nowhere to hide!
shit! alive. Come on! You're dead!
Yeah, I'll enjoy getting out of
Every time. Hey, boy.
Yep.
Yep.
clear out before you got some angry O'Driscolls for company.
Come on, boy. Yep. Get up. Yeah. Thank you.
think you've been robbing grain.
Let's go, boy.
Yep.
So up now. Okay, boy.
Yeah.
Hey, Arthur. Good to see you.
Why? You want rescuing?
There's a spot up this way with a good view of the trail.
What are you doing anyway, camping out here like some crazy hermit?
Can't exactly stay in town now, can I? And like I told you, I ain't going back to Dutch without a peace offering.
So what's the deal with this coach?
What do you mean? Comes through about this time every day, like I said, the end.
I mean, how many men, guns, riders?
Nothing serious. It'll be fine.
I heard the bank's been hiring every trigger man they can get of late. The meaner, the better.
You worry too much.
Forgive me if I ain't wholly faithful in something an old Driscoll told you when you was half drunk in a jail cell.
He kept yapping about it, saying how they've been hitting it on the regular. That's a good lead in my book. What's the problem now?
Christ. O'Driscolls are everywhere now.
Bastards got a hold of most of Big Valley. Heard they took over some big ranch north of here.
How the hell you and Lenny end up down here, anyway?
Well, you know how it is. A few loose ends. Drink here, drink there. Hey, what are you getting off for?
Concerns me when you put us in danger and we don't realize till it's too late. Like that move you pulled at Strawberry, making me kill half the town just for your precious guns.
Precious they are. You need to roll a little looser, Morgan.
Looser? I seen you come full undone more than once now, and you only been running with us a few months.
Are we gonna rob this coach or bicker about it? What's done is easy. What's done is done.
Guess we're robbing it.
Then let's do it. Can't you ride, damn it? God damn it! All right, this is the spot. Hold up on this ridge. They should be here in a little bit. Hold tight.
Which way will they be coming in?
Should be from over there. We need to hit them fast before they get into town.
Just don't lose your head this time.
Of course, tough guy. They should be here any minute. Look, there they are. Right on time. Get covered up. Come on! Ride! Yeah! This is a robbery! Stop that! Boats right now!
Not again, you sons of bitches! Gun them down!
Do this the hard way, do ya?
bitches, gun them down.
Yeah.
Need to keep your face covered now. It's just you and me, sweetheart. I'll give it to them. They put up half a fight at least. Yeah! Baylock! Come on, boy! Look here. Fine new rifle, too. Here you go, Arthur. From me to you. That's more your style than mine. What did I tell you? Like licking butter off a knife.
Something like that. You don't want to just break it open here, be done with it?
Could be more than we can carry. And there might be a second crew of riders tailing.
All right, then.
Not to mention, we ride back in with a big take and a new wagon to boot. Judge can't say we ain't pulling our weight no more, can he?
I ain't sure I trust this new act of yours one bit.
Listen, I know we got off on the wrong foot, but I got no beef with you. I reckon we're a lot alike, you and me.
Now, hold up there.
Judge knows I'm a feller that gets things done, same as you.
Dick shit! Now we're being robbed! Get across the river!
What the hell?
Come on, Arthur! Get out of there! You dumb bastards!
Damn! You okay?
I think so. Just keep your head down.
Let's finish.
They're goddamn O'Driscolls!
I can see that!
We're going over!
Watch yourself!
is it? Every job I do with you ends in a pile of dead bodies.
Since when did you have a problem killing O'Driscolls?
You've got a point.
Let's strip this coach then. It clearly ain't going nowhere now. You know, we should really pick up a lock breaker one of these days. Save ourselves some bullets.
Yeah, because saving bullets is such a concern of yours.
Let's take what we can and get the hell out of here. That lock should shoot off easy enough. I'll give you the honors. On account of, well, this little mess.
We killers us over it!
Just don't you want the honors.
Thank you.
All right, boy.
Come on, let's see if all this was worth it.
All I see is you, me, a river full of dead O'Driscolls, and a lockbox. I'd say we're golden here, Morgan. Look at that.
Hey.
What's the cut here?
It's good. Just make sure the gang gets its piece.
Yeah, yeah. Like I said, big shadow,
tiny tree.
And like I said, that still don't mean... Okay, boy. Let's go.
Don't come any closer!
Yep.
Mr. Morgan.
You seem chipper.
Well, where there's life, there's hope, my friend.
And?
Morning, Mr. Morgan.
Arthur?
Hi, Mary Beth. Hello.
How about you bring that pretty little face over here for a kiss?
Well done, Arthur. You found the Irish Terrier.
Sadly.
He's just a younger version of you.
Please don't say that to me, Dutch.
Oh, it's true. It's true.
Morning, Arthur.
You know something? You boys don't know you're born. This isn't tough. This is easy. Easy. Tough as a dead cow. Surrounded by icebergs. Slowly starving. And then the boat comes down with the plague. And men are dying like it's a race. The parson, he can't keep up with the funerals. We're burying them 2-3 at a time, okay, and there's 50 sharks chasing the boat just to feast on the corpses. This is a picnic.
What you preparing for?
The greatest of gifts.
An unguarded stagecoach.
No, you simple-minded fool. Bison.
Bison?
Bison, from which you can get anything. There's some over on the plains, I believe. I saw a couple a long way off.
Oh. You look.
You want to come with me? I'll show you how we hunt one.
Sure. Why not?
Mount up then. Let's go. It was before my time, of course, but my mother used to tell me stories of how her tribe moved with the bison. They lived almost as one. Where the bison went, my people went. And they were the center of all life. We couldn't survive without them. They provided us with everything. Food, clothing, shelter, tools. There was a lot of respect.
Huh. I don't remember much of my childhood, but I think my people... Well, we pretty much moved with the whiskey.
Well, my father did that too. Let's try over here, to the left. Over there. You see them all? Incredible, aren't they? We should only kill one of them. I'll keep them ringed in and you see if you can bring one down. Okay? Clean as you can.
Okay. Yep.
We should only kill one of them. I'll keep them ringed in and you see if you can bring one down. Okay? Clean as you can.
Okay.
Well done. All right. Skin and butcher. Take the horns too. It can all be used. Job. Stow that on your horse and mount up. I wanna go check something out.
Okay, let's go. Where are we going?
I thought I saw some scavenger birds over here. I just wanted to see what attracted them. No.
Look. Bison. Shot and left for dead, it looks like.
Why would someone do that?
I don't know. But I see tracks heading in this direction. I say we follow them.
All right. Lead the way. Been dead a couple of days, at least. Already starting to rot. Been an animal?
No, they've been shot. I just don't know why anybody would just leave them here to rot like that. Another dead bison, on the hill to the right. Come on. Shot and left for dead again. But this one looks fresher.
There's a camp there. I'm gonna take a look. Haven't gone cold yet. Maybe half a day since they left.
Bison's been dead about the same amount of time.
So what do you want to do?
They could still be in the area. Let's get up higher. See if we spot anything.
Christ alive!
This way. We should have a good view from up here.
I see some smoke to the east. Maybe another camp. It's worth a look.
All right. Let's go.
We can talk.
I don't kill for fun. I kill when I need to. Look, more dead bison. It has to be them. Come on.
Wait up.
Did you fools shoot those bison?
What's your problem?
I said, did you fools shoot those bison?
Calm down, you black or red bastard, whatever the fuck you are.
Did you shoot them?
Yes, we did. We shot them bison, we'll shoot you too if you don't get...
What business is it of yours? What? We...
It's that business of mine!
Good God, you're crazy! I got a family. A family. Don't shoot me!
Stand back, Charles. I'll get you some answers.
What the hell are you doing?
Why are you killing those bison and leaving them to rot?
I don't know what you're talking about!
God damn it, tell us or you're dead!
Oh, okay! We were paid to kill as many as we could, and to make it look like it was Indians.
Just kill him, Arthur.
No. Please, don't kill me.
I've heard enough.
Damn right. That's what he deserved. I've seen enough of this. I'm heading back.
Okay. I'm gonna see if there's anything worth taking from their camp. I'll catch up with you later. Yep.
Hey, partner.
Well, howdy.
Chinese fellers been taking all the jobs around here. Ain't no wonder we're all turning to crime.
I can give you a little. This? It ain't worth much. Seems everyone with a rifle been hunting these of late.
That rat bastard can go to hell for all I care.
That's so.
This poor fella been torn up. Drops the price, I'm afraid. A lot of folk coming by with these lately. I can give you a little.
Been a pleasure doing business with you.
Let me know how it works.
Ah! Get in quick, folks, before I eat all these.
What's them hold up?
Welcome back, sir. Got everything you need. Have a look. Sure, I'm always willing to stack up. Well, that's done. Okay, then.
Much appreciated. Lightens my load. Thank you.
Look out!
Watch it. You got a problem or something?
Howdy, partner. First time? Gum, candies, tobacco, all the good stuff are on the shelves behind my counter. Tonics and medicines are on the table over there. Everything else, you should see the catalog. Sure, what you got?
I hope you change your mind.
New Hanover Gazette.
Oh, there you are. What can I do for you? Careful with the pages.
So. Yeah, I heard that too.
Did you say something? Wind's making it hard to hear.
Tell me about it.
Well. All right. This'll be here when you need it. You keep treating that like your own child, all right? Good on you. How about you get some new sights for this, huh?
Well, hello there.
Smart addition. Dangerous. Good. Ain't no trace of rust on that as far as I can see. Hey, it's beautiful condition. Keep it up. Those old Driscoll boys have been seen rustling again up at Phoenix Sky Ranch. Good. Ain't no trace of rust on that as far as I can see. I got some nice carved stocks here. I think you should take one.
That's great.
Well, it doesn't hurt to stock up on ammo. You never know. You keep treating that like your own child, all right? Good on you. Yeah, beautiful condition. Keep it up. Hank told me a man of the clergy joined a poker game down at Flat Neck Station. So drunk, he could hardly play.
Cannot wait to give this a try.
Thanks, mister.
Believe this? Went to the shop looking for a new rifle, and there's hardly a gun that costs less than 2 weeks' wages.
You ever let this horse feed?
We've got room in the stable if you need it. Real fine saddles here. It's better to equip yourself and not need it than the other way around. Excellent choice, sir. You can tell the difference with these additions. I think you should do it. Goes well with a saddle. You can't have too much with you out in the wilderness. It's better to equip yourself and not need it than the other way around. Thanks for your business. You can't have too much with you out in the wilderness. Do you know, horses just love a lump of sugar. Just my two cents. Horses are friendlier than people. They make the most loyal friends. Ain't no one knows horses better than me. I really think your horse will appreciate it. Very fashionable. It'll look great on your horse. Now, don't that look fine? Absolutely. Good decision. You and that horse are always welcome.
Well, my partner's feeling like about time.
Welcome. In the mood for a show?
Which show is it today?
We are showing the bear today.
Come on, boy.
Don't hesitate too long. You don't want to miss the show.
Welcome back, Arthur.
Come on.
Keep me company.
Stop it!
This really, Mr. Bell?
I disagree.
You flatter me.
Why are you so afraid of a pair of gelding tongs? I thought you were the horse expert.
How's it going?
When I was frisky, over some poles and whiskey. Like the waves of the Bay of the Biscay. I began to tumble and roar.
Hey there.
My face was as red as a lobster. I fell and broke my poor knobster.
Well, I'll be cooked myself if I don't move.
How you doing?
Good, thanks.
That's good.
John?
Let's get on.
Good. And you?
Got everything we need.
Good. I think we need another man. Charles?
I'll go get him. Meet us at the wagon when you can.
Sure.
See you, Arthur. Ain't that dumb.
Next time, let the wolves eat all your brain. Then you'll be a genius.
Who did you call a goddamn drunkard?
some shit.
I got no idea.
Hey, Arthur. Come here a minute.
What is it?
Can I ask you a favor?
Probably not.
Very funny. Would you do something with Jack? He seems kind of down. All this upheaval can't have been easy on the poor kid.
Why? Because I'm your preferred nursemaid?
Please, Arthur. The boy's been through a lot.
What you up to?
Playing.
Anything fun?
I guess.
You want to come fishing with me?
Fishing?
Sure. It's about time that you started to earn your keep.
Okay.
Good. Let's go get your pole in. Now, you do have a fishing pole, don't you?
I sure do. Uncle Jose made me one.
Good. Well, let's go get it then. Go catch us some fish.
Yeah.
Okay, boy. All right, hold on tight.
So, where are we going?
Just down to the river near here. We shouldn't go too far from camp.
Oh, okay.
You feeling better? I know you was a little sick.
Oh, I'm fine.
You're a brave kid.
So, just like you.
Well, I don't know about brave. I ain't much of a kid no more. Though your mama might disagree. Her and a few other women, I guess.
What do you mean?
I'm just talking silly. It's been a tough few weeks up in that snow.
I like the snow.
Yes, but not like that.
When are we going back to the other camp?
The one near Blackwater?
Yeah.
Well, we're not. This is our spot. For now, anyway. Why?
I forgot a storybook there. We left so quick.
All right. This looks as good a spot as any.
Where should we stand, Uncle Arthur?
Down by the shore. Come on, follow me.
Are you waiting for something?
First, we need some bait. I'm gonna use some cheese.
Cheese?
Smellier the better. Now, cast your line. Swing the rod back over your shoulder and bring it forward in a smooth motion. Use your wrist, not your elbow.
Like that?
That's it. Good. All we do now, Jack, is wait for a fish to take the bait.
How do I know when I've got a bite?
Well, if you feel the tip of your fishing rod just twitching, don't yank it yet. That just means one's nimbling. If you feel a hard tug, that's a fish going for the bait, so yank hard to hook it.
You've got a bite, Uncle Arthur?
There! Got him!
Is it a big one?
See him fighting there, Jack? That's when you gotta be careful. You'll break the line. Best to wear him out first before you try to reel him in. Now, seems like he's taking a rest now. I'm gonna try reeling him in nice and steady.
This is a great fishing spot.
Don't jinx it, kid. You okay there?
I think so. This is hard. Why am I not catching any?
Just be patient.
My arms are tired.
You're all right. You know, this reminds me. I taught another boy to fish once, a long time ago.
You mean Lenny?
No. No, this was long before I met Lenny. Long before you was even born. Look, Jack, it's a bluegill. It's almost as small as you. We should really throw these smaller ones back. Give him a chance to grow up a bit.
Can I take a break from fishing? I want to make something.
Okay.
Pick some of those red flowers. I'll be right back.
All right. Let's see what's biting there. Fish on the line. This one's a rock bass. Not bad.
Fishing sure is boring, Uncle Arthur.
I know. Boring as hell. But then, something happens. And you can get food for days.
Really?
If you're lucky. But until then, you just sit and wait and try not to worry. It's good for you.
It's good for you?
I guess.
Huh. I think you got a
bite.
Look.
Ah, damn it. You get him.
Hey, look at this.
And what?
This necklace I made.
Necklace?
For Mama.
Sure.
What a fine young man. And in such complex circumstances. Arthur, isn't it? Arthur Morgan?
Who are you?
Yes, Arthur Morgan, Vander Lynn's most trusted associate. You've read the files. Typical case, orphaned street kid seduced by that maniac's silver tongue and matures into a degenerate murderer. Agent Milton, Agent Ross, Pinkerton Detective Agency, seconded to the United States government. Nice to finally meet. We know a lot about you.
Do you?
You're a wanted man, Mr. Morgan. It's $5,000 for your head alone.
$5,000? For me? Can I turn myself in?
We want Vanderlyn.
Old Dutch. I haven't seen him for months.
That's so. Because I heard a guy fitting his description robbed a train belonging to Leviticus Cornwall up near Granite Pass.
Oh, ain't that a little old-fashioned nowadays?
Apparently not. Listen. This is my offer, Mr. Morgan. Bring in Vanderlyn, and you have my word you won't swing.
Oh, I ain't gonna swing anyways, Agent,
Milton.
You see, I haven't done anything wrong, aside from not play the games to your rules.
Spare me the philosophy lesson. I've already heard it from Mac Callender.
Mac Callender?
He was pretty shot up by the time I got to him. So really, it was more of a mercy killing. Slow, but merciful.
You enjoy being a rich man's toy, do you?
I enjoy society, flaws and all. You people venerate savagery, and you will die. Savagely, all of you.
Oh, we're all gonna die, Agent.
Some of us sooner than others. Good day, Mr. Morgan.
Goodbye. It's getting late, Jack. Your mother would be worried. Let's head back.
I don't like it here anymore. Are you taking me back?
You idiot.
Why did you lie about where Uncle Dutch is?
Because, well, because those are disagreeable men, and I don't want them to hurt him.
What did they mean about Mac? Is he in jail?
No, I don't think so. I hope he's just fine where he is. Like I said, don't worry about them. The world is full of disagreeable men. That's why you got all of us, to protect you from folk like them. Now, how about that necklace you made? You still got it, right?
Yeah, I got it.
Good. Well, did you like fishing?
It was okay, I think. It's a lot of waiting around.
It is.
Great! We caught a fish, and I made you this necklace.
Ain't that pretty? We had the luckiest... Did you thank Uncle Arthur?
No need. We had a good time.
What's wrong?
Nothing. Just met some folk. I better go speak with Dutch.
Okay.
Hey, you did real fine, kid.
Thanks.
We got a problem.
What?
I just met some guys out near the river. A fella named, Milton, and, I don't remember the other fella's name. Ross. Milton and Ross.
And
they are employees of the Pinkerton Detective Agency. And they know about the train, and they know we're here.
Well, you followed back here.
No, they know we're near here. And they want you, Dutch. They offered me my freedom in exchange, they did.
Why didn't you take it?
Very funny. Well, what do we do now?
I say we do nothing. Just yet. They're just trying to scare us into doing something stupid. We have turned a corner. We survived them mountains. We just need to stay calm. Okay, boy.
Morning, Arthur.
Yeah. Easy now. Was you? Yep. Let's go, boy. Yeah. Show it up. Giddy up. Easy, easy.
Back.
We make a way.
I'm the bear.
Back to work, boy. Get you.
Well, at least it ain't your job.
Shut up, Arthur.
Yeah, your job's starting the fights. It ain't winning them.
We can scrap, Arthur. I'm just no good at homework.
I can see.
Besides, what do you care, Englishman? You've got no time for me. I tried to find you work, but then you're off cutting jobs with other folks, and your boy Sean doesn't get a look in.
Guess I don't want to get shot, that's all.
Yeah, you're a real fucking funny shit, Arthur Morgan, huh? Real fucking funny.
Calm down.
You better sleep with your eyes open.
Yeah, well, you're gonna sleep with your chest open if you ain't careful, boy.
I love you, Arthur Morgan.
Hey, all the horses untethered?
Think so.
Good. They should follow on behind us.
We're never gonna get there at this rate.
You find a good spot, Wolfman?
Yeah. Follow the trail southwest. There's a spot that's remote, but should still give them enough time to spot the oil wagon.
They see this blocking the tracks, they'll stop soon enough.
Go easy on them horses, will you? Apparently, picks up a new team of guards at the state line, so shouldn't be too much in the way of guns to deal with.
What the hell? Drive on the road!
See? This is what I mean. I disappear for a couple of weeks, and you cut me out of all the action.
Hey, slow down.
They're left here, towards Rhodes. Just the action that requires a brain.
Ha ha ha. You're a funny fella, John Marston.
Hey, hey, take it easy.
My folks, eh? You had your feet up the whole time, playing sick and fondling at your scar. Like you're gonna buy a breakfast in the morning.
You're gonna hurt the horses.
Hey, all the horses untethered?
Think so.
Good. They should follow on behind us.
You find a good spot, Wolfman?
Get back on the road. Yeah, follow the trail southwest. There's a spot that's remote, but should still give them enough time to spot the oil wagon.
They see this blocking the tracks, they'll stop soon enough.
Apparently. Picks up a new team of guards at the state line, so shouldn't be too much in the way of guns to deal with. Drive on the road, for Christ's sakes! See? This is what I mean. I disappear for a couple of weeks, and you cut me out of all the action. Slow down! Now we've gone and lost the horse.
Yep. Hey, all the horses untethered?
Think so.
Good. They should follow on behind us.
You find a good spot, Wolfman?
Yeah. Follow the trail southwest. There's a spot that's remote, but should still give them enough time to spot the oil wagon.
They see this block in the tracks, they'll stop soon enough.
Apparently. Picks up a new team of guards at the state line, so shouldn't be too much in the way of guns to deal with.
Are you crazy?
All the horses untethered?
Think so.
Good. They should follow on behind us.
You find a good spot, Wolfman?
Yeah. Follow the trail southwest. There's a spot that's remote, but you should still give them enough time to spot the oil wagon.
All the horses untethered?
Think so.
Good. They should follow on behind us.
You find a good spot, Wolfman?
Yeah. Follow the trail southwest. There's a spot that's remote, but should still give them enough time to spot the oil wagon.
They see this block in the tracks, they'll stop soon enough.
Apparently. Picks up a new team of guards at the state line, so shouldn't be too much in the way of guns to deal with.
See? This is what I mean. I disappear for a couple of weeks and you cut me out of all the action.
Just the action that requires a brain.
Ha ha ha. You're a funny fella, John Marston. And my folks, eh? You had your feet up the whole time, playing sick, and fondling that new scar like you're gonna buy a breakfast in the morning.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Stay close on this. Wouldn't want you getting scratched by a squirrel or something.
They're left here. Towards Rhodes.
What was I talking about? That could put you out of commission for the rest of the year.
Why do you have to speak so much? It's incessant.
Because I've still got some blood in me veins. You old bastards have forgotten how to live.
I blame you two for rescuing him.
Far too much trouble for what we got out of it.
Yeah. Takes a whole army of bounty hunters to bring in Sean Maguire. And look at me now. In the Gunner Sea. Back in business, boys. You know, my dad always used to say...
Not the dad,
no,
please.
Not this again.
Fine. Damn you three. Sulky, angry, scarface. A right barrel of laughs.
Yeah.
So, we blocked the tracks with the wagon, then jump them. That's the plan.
Pretty much. Charles, you deal with the engineer. John, secure the passenger car fast. Take charitable donations and make sure everyone behaves. Little Mr. Maguire, you focus on the baggage car.
Here's good. Stop the wagon over the tracks. Remember, these are innocent folks. You handle this right, no.
Mr. Marston, Mr. Smith, Mr. Maguire. Get over there. When she slows, order.
And you?
I'm gonna make sure she slows.
That's do or die with you. I like it.
Get moving. Here she comes.
What's going on?
Nothing.
looking good.
I need to get up there. Finish up here and join us on board.
All right, get on that train! All yours, Captain. Well, go on ahead.
Everybody stay calm and don't try to get shot. Go!
This is unnecessary.
Everything you got. Money, valuable.
What did I do? I'm begging you.
There you go. Let's make this quick, people. Come on. We ain't leaving till this bag's full.
Please. I'll do anything.
Don't do this.
I ain't got nothing.
Want to have a little chat with Romeo and Juliet here?
Just chat.
This is unnecessary. Please.
Maybe we're dying over.
What's the problem?
Tell him, Mr. M.
I don't want to get hurt.
Come on! In the bag, everything you got. Keep it coming. Don't be shy.
I'm not a bad man.
No, please.
People like you make me sick.
Don't do it.
You seem to think we're playing games.
Je vous en prie. Don't do this. Please.
Don't help me, Mr. M.
Taking a look yet?
Probably something in here, Arthur.
Cover.
I'll try me best, brother, but I'm seeing double here.
That gives you twice the chance of hitting someone.
Very funny.
Gonna have a right out lump on me head.
At least you ain't got a hole in it.
Are those tennis rackets in there? Harsh bastards.
Just keep your eyes peeled.
I'm doing me best, all right.
I know. That's what's worrying me. We'll take that.
You nearly done? Come on, we should get out of here.
All right, we should probably be going now.
Some decent stuff. Looking good in here.
Arthur, we've got a problem. There's two assholes on horses.
How many you say?
I just see a pair of them.
All right, in that case, we're fighting. Austin, Smith, get ready.
You men come out the train now, do you hear? We said you men come out now.
There's only two of you, you fools. We got a whole lot less to lose. Why don't the two of you ride away? That way neither of you get killed. Goddamn liberties.
There's a few more of them torn enough.
Man, my big mouth. Okay, let's deal with them.
Left check.
Shit, we got more on the left. We got more coming from the trees there.
Boys, let's get the hell out of here! We need to move now, Morgan! What are you doing?
Ride! Let's lose them! Yep.
Let's get out of here.
Come on. We need to move now.
Let's go. Why are you playing up?
Whoa! Whoa!